I'm Andrew Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another one of my guitar lessons. This time we're going to be running through some ideas that have to do with bossa nova rhythms for guitar, and we're just going to touch base as well a little bit on the world of melody along with that. Now, this came to us as a question from Luka. He is out in London, England, and he wrote in saying, can you work out a lesson on a few different ways to play bossa nova rhythm ideas? I'd like to know the basic rhythm to start with, plus how to make it more advanced. Could you also mention a word or two on how to cover the chords with some basic melody? These riffs don't seem to stay inside one key, and that gets me confused for melody. From Luka in London, England. Hey, thanks for writing in, Luka. Latin guitar styles are really nice rhythm styles to learn and play and practice, and they offer guitar players a really great way to explore the Afro-Cuban sound. There is a good groove to this style, and with respect to the melody work, it's quite interesting as well. The melodies follow the chords very closely, so we'll get a chance to apply much of the same rhythms, and we'll use modes and arpeggio concepts in there for just going and tracking the melodic coverage. Now, in this lesson, I'm going to introduce the basic bossa rhythm groove and also demonstrate a slightly more complex pattern that can embellish the feel. Aside from the rhythmic ideas, I'll also be working through a few tips for creating melody. And this will involve both tracking chord changes and the use of targeted modes and arpeggios to cover the chords. So let's get started. We won't waste any more time. Let's zoom in on the neck and get this lesson going. Our first bossa nova ideas are going to look at rhythmic patterns, and in bossa nova, we most commonly have grooves that use two measure patterns. They're derived from Afro-Cuban concepts called the clave, and these grooves are repetitive. They can be created from an almost unlimited combination of different rhythmic patterns. In the first couple of examples for this lesson, I'm going to show you some of the more commonly played bossa patterns in their most basic form. But overall, just to give you a quick demo, I'm just going to tap on my guitar and give you a concept about how those things fit together. So here's an example of that groove. That's the feel in a basic form, but what I want to do, of course, is take that feel and put it on top of a chord so we can have some harmony with that. And what I'm going to do is just take a static chord of an F dominant 9, and I'm going to put that groove on it. So this is in your handout, by the way, as example number one. Here's how it sounds. So you can tell it's very punchy, and it comes across when we have those chord attacks as very staccato. It's very short and detached. So you want to make sure that you're playing it that way once you get the feel together. And then also the other side of this too is you can tell in between those chords get muted. So in between the attacks, we're stopping that chord. You can hear it stop. Now I'm stopping it primarily by touching my fingers, my playing hand fingers, on the strings as I'm jamming out on that riff. So, take your time through this, understand how it all fits together, be able to hear the groove in your head, because that's a huge aspect of this, and then over time, you just speed it up, just get it faster and faster. But so we're going to take a short break, come back in example two with a little bit of a variation on this initial groove here. Well, in the next example, we're going to take a look at a variation on the initial groove that we learned back in example one. Keep in mind that the bossa nova functions, of course, using that Latin clave, which is a two-measure pattern, and the clave serves as the basis for nearly all styles of Latin music. So always remember that. That's the key to getting your groove down. Understand how that works, be able to clap it and count it, and then take it to your chords, so you're going to have a little bit easier time. Now in example two, the clave is going to be based around tying the chord over the bar line and into the next upcoming measure. And this groove will focus more upon the chord's roots and won't place a lot of emphasis upon the alternating bass note as we had seen in example one. In fact, this groove is not going to have a alternating bass note at all. In fact, the other interesting thing about this groove here in example two is it's going to operate across two different chord types. They're going to be a half step apart. The chords are going to be E6-9 and also F dominant 9. So here's how the groove functions. It goes like this. It's in your handout under example two. All Now, you know, this idea is really interesting because of the way that chord is getting tied over the measure. It's going to be the F dominant 9 chord, by the way. So we come in off that E6 9. And then we have that F9 come in, the top half of it, and then on the downbeat of the next measure, we have that lone bass note. So the chord is tied over, and then we have the bass note come in. Kind of an interesting sound. Here it is again. All right. So it's kind of a cool, you know, concept, and it's different, of course, you know, as example one was laid out. Example two here has a little bit different feel. Now, one more thing, though, while we're still on this whole topic of playing the rhythms and jamming out all the rhythm changes that I need to mention here is, you know, there's sort of a 60-40 split out there of guitar players who are doing this stuff fingerstyle. I'd probably say fingerstyle is the more predominant way. And then there's another group of players out there that are using a flat pick. And what's happening here is we're doing a technique called hybrid picking, where you hold the pick in between your thumb and index finger, and then you're using your ring through small fingers, or your middle through small fingers, pardon me, to get the other upper strings in there. So it's kind of an interesting technique if you've never messed around with it. It does give you a little bit more boomy bass note there. So you can tell it's a bit louder. So definitely keep that in mind. You know, if you are really into hybrid picking, that can be another way to function with the rhythm grooves in this style. And it's definitely not something that should be overlooked, because you can get a lot more dynamics out of that bass note doing hybrid picking technique. Well, even though Bossa Nova uses a simple repeating rhythmic pattern, its harmony can be complex since it applies mainly extended jazz harmonies. Now, we already know that the Bossa Nova groove is generally played slowly with a smooth feel to it, which is actually going to help us when we're composing melodies over the chord changes. So in example 3 of the handout, I wanted to start with a melody line that'll cover two unrelated chords that are typically found in this style. They're going to be an F major 7 and then E dominant 7th. Now within that F major 7 in the first two measures, I'm also going to scoot up and I'm going to take in 6-9 as well. So F6-9 with the F major 7. And then when we get to the E dominant 7th, just kind of keep it really basic over that chord. Okay. That's going to be the groove in the background, and to cover these chords, we're going to track the harmony by way of some pentatonic, a little bit of arpeggios, and of course modes as well. Now, for those of you who are not very theoretically inclined, haven't done a lot of practice on guitar with scales and so forth, and especially modes, I know this is going to sound complicated, but you have to educate yourself on these ideas. And in the beginning, if you're uneducated, just choose one idea to make things easier. You can just maybe select pentatonic or a small portion of an arpeggio and work out something for each chord. Take it slow, build lines like that, and then over time, of course, you know, you get better and better doing this. Now, to cover the F major, what we're going to look at doing there is using a start of things through an arpeggio located within the chord. It's going to be an A minor arpeggio. And that's going to cover the F major sounds. But when we get to the E dominant 7th, I'm going to be using an E mixolydian mode. So that's how we're going to do the coverage in the example. You can find the example in your handout under example 3. And I do have these chord changes going on the loop pedal, so I'm going to fire that up, give you a chance to hear those chords going by, and then I'm going to play the melody on top. So let's get started. All right. right? So I know it seems simple when you have something established like this already, but the thing to do is start slowly, cover the chord tones, write them out on a piece of paper if you have to, write out the scales on some scale diagram paper, and really get yourself up to speed on being able to target chord tones and play into chords that are unrelated and are functioning in a non-diatonic manner. It's really important as you're developing your skills as a musician to be able to do this. Now we're going to take a short break, come back in a moment, and we're going to check out in example 4 where we're going to do a few more advanced ideas with the melodies. Well, other bossa nova harmonies are going to contain specific chord tones that can be highlighted in the melodies in order to really bring out the sound of each chord of the progression. So, in my final example, I wanted to showcase this type of idea and also discuss how this thing can be worked out and these chord tones can be targeted specifically. Now, the chords in example 4 are going to be A minor 7 to an A minor 6. Then we're going to move up into a B dominant 7, and then we're going to have a B7 sharp 5. And the groove will go like this. All right. Now, in building a melody around this kind of harmony, I wanted to target into the extended and altered tones. So over that A minor harmony, I'm going to start by outlining the A minor 7 with just a triad arpeggio. Then I'm going to do a little bit of a chromatic line, targeting right into that fifth there, the E. So sort of like a target into the fifth chord tone, perfect fifth. And then what we're going to do after that is work more towards the major six of that minor six chord. Now, if you're not familiar with chord tones and how they operate within chords, even if the chord is minor, the added extension is going to be major. So whether that's a ninth or a sixth or a 13th or whatnot, in this case off this A minor seven chord, if I add in a six, it's going to be a major six. It would be an F sharp added to that chord. If you're not familiar with your chord tone ideas, chord construction ideas, definitely study that stuff. It's super important to understand it. And basically that, you know, wraps up the sounds of the A minor deal. Now, when we move to the B dominant 7, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to target both the lowered 7th and the major 3rd of that B dominant 7th chord. Those are really integral chord tones. So the lowered 7th is an A. The major 3rd is basically D sharp. So I have that targeted out in the melody. But I also am going to use some chromatic ideas to build toward a really important tone for us, and it's going to be the sharp 5. Now, it looks to us in the chords breakdown as if it's a G, and you could certainly call it a G. It's an enharmonic equivalent, but really the name of it would be F double sharp. So, if you're not familiar with your theory on this stuff, check out your theory and do some studying. I have a theory course you could, you know, buy and go through the material and get your information together. It's just not great to be out to lunch on your theory examples because they're so crucial to really building you as a much better musician. But we're going to look at it maybe in terms of a G natural. But that's going to be part of a chromatic concept, too, that we're going to move around there. Oh, hang on a second. It's chromatic from 7, 8, 9. Pardon me. Targeting into that G. So there it is. Then we're going to head over to the 10th fret. And we're going to have sort of like a bluesy, you know, flat 5 sound on that note into the 4th degree, and then we're going to move down and go more toward the building toward the major 3rd again by way of a line that's going to come from the 5th fret of 3rd string. It's a C to a D up to a D sharp, and if you'll recall, the D sharp is the major 3rd of that chord, so that's going to be a really nice ending tone. So there it is. So it's a really interesting sound. Now, this whole melody comes together over these changes to sound like this. All right, so it's a really neat sound. It's really got some cool stuff going on with the chromatics, and there's a lot of chord tone targeting, as you can tell. So, you know, it's very complex on one level because you really have to know your chord tones and able to enable you to do that. But I have those changes in the loop pedal. I want to fire that up now. I'm going to play this melody over those chord changes to take you out. So here we go. Thank you. know, playing bossa nova guitar is a style that really offers up an interesting way for students to get involved with the world of finger picking. If finger picking is new to you, bossa nova style is really great to get exposure in that particular technique. The rhythm parts have, of course, an alternating bass note idea working over a majority of the chords. But, you know, sometimes you have to keep in mind that, you know, some chords just, they won't be conducive to being able to remain on the alternating root to third or root to fifth. On some chords, you're just going to have to remain on the root only. The bass note patterns are kind of optional, so you know you can be the judge on how they get played. When it comes down to playing melodies, we can get the most out of the chord changes in this style by targeting the chord tones. If you're unfamiliar with how to do this type of melodic technique, you'll probably need to study it for a while until it makes more sense to you. Chord tone targeting, or playing sort of more in a jazz style, of course, is a more advanced melodic technique, but like anything else, once you start studying it, it of course can be learned. Anyhow, that's all the time I have for now. I want to say once again, thanks for watching, and have fun working on all this information. You can download the handout and an MP3 jam track for this video over at my website at andrewwasson.com. You can follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook, and subscribe to my other guitar blog YouTube channel. That's an excellent channel as well. There's hundreds of guitar lessons on there. And every Sunday, there's a Sunday release, sort of like the master class lesson of that channel. It comes out on Sundays. And then Monday to Thursday, there's a great series I'm running on there. It's called Micro Lessons. And I think you're really going to enjoy those. They're only around 2 minutes long, and it gives you a chance to learn a guitar riff or a lick or part of a solo every one of those days. So it's a great booster shot for your guitar lessons. Anyhow, the links for all this stuff are in the description box for you. Just take care, have a great week, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.